Thanks to Wondrium for supporting this SciShow video. Wondrium is a subscription service where you find the answers to everything you've ever wondered about, and some things you've never imagined you would wonder about. Head to wondrium.com/scishow for a free trial. Even if you didn't go through a rocks and minerals phase as a kid, you've probably heard some facts about those sparkly, sparkly diamonds. Like that they're the hardest mineral on Earth, and that they're a dog's best friend. No, wait, that's not how the song goes. Dogs are a girl's best friend. Anyway, it turns out that first fact might not be right either. There's another naturally occurring mineral out there that could be harder than diamond. It's just a little hard to study because it's only found in rocks that fell from space. When geologists describe a mineral as hard, they aren't talking about how it feels to the touch. They're talking about how scratch-proof it is. You may have heard diamonds have a hardness of 10 out of 10. That's according to the Mohs mineral hardness scale. And the test behind this scale is really simple. You drag one mineral across another. If you see a line left behind, whether with your eye or under a microscope, that mineral is less hard than the one you scratched it with. The higher a mineral's Mohs number, the fewer minerals it can be scratched by. So, with their hardness of 10, diamonds are nearly unscratchable. They can scratch each other, and while some synthetic materials might be able to scratch them, we haven't found a naturally occurring mineral that can. But what makes diamonds so hard? It's partially due to the fact that they're made entirely of carbon atoms. When atoms come together to make minerals, they form a lattice held together by chemical bonds. Depending on the atoms involved, these bonds come in two main flavors, ionic bonds and covalent bonds. In ionic bonds, electrons are transferred from one atom to another. And ionic bonds can be strong, but they aren't usually as strong as covalent bonds, where electrons are shared. Corundum, the mineral that makes both rubies and sapphires, has both types of bonds. Its aluminum atoms will transfer electrons to nearby oxygen atoms to form ionic bonds, and the oxygen atoms will covalently share electrons between each other. So in the end, it has a Mohs hardness of 9. Because diamond is pure carbon, it only uses covalent bonds. But that alone can't explain why a diamond is harder than a ruby. Despite looking completely different, graphite is also pure carbon. And while diamonds are over here rocking a 10 in Mohs hardness, graphite ranks about a 1.5. It's so soft that your fingernail can dent it. So we also have to consider the shape of the mineral's lattice. How the atoms are actually arranged. Graphite atoms come stacked in two-dimensional sheets. Each carbon atom is bound to three others in the same sheet. And while the covalent bonds within the sheets are strong, the sheets are bound to each other very weakly. When force is applied to graphite, like you pressing your pencil lead against a sheet of paper, the structure deforms pretty easily. Meanwhile, a diamond's atoms are arranged in a three-dimensional cubic structure, with each carbon atom bound to four of its neighbors. Unlike graphite, it resists force from three dimensions. So, hypothetically, if we wanted to find a mineral harder than diamond, we'd look for something that was still pure carbon, but had a better lattice structure. Enter lonsdaleite. Lonsdaleite's atoms are arranged hexagonally. Each carbon is covalently bound to six other atoms. These two extra bonds per atom should produce an even harder mineral. Unfortunately, scientists have had a hard time confirming that's true, because while we've known about lonsdaleite since the 1960s, we haven't found pure lonsdaleite in large enough samples to really test it. See, lonsdaleite is natural, but as far as we know, it doesn't occur naturally on Earth. The only lonsdaleite we have comes from a special class of meteorites called uraeolites. These are carbon-rich meteorites that scientists think all come from the same source, a dwarf planet that was destroyed by a collision very early in the solar system's history. And when you crack uraeolites open, you can find some graphite, diamond, and, at least in a few samples, teeny amounts of lonsdaleite. Sometimes you can even see transition zones between these different minerals. That suggests that some kind of shock forced the carbon atoms to rearrange themselves, and for some reason, some formed diamond while others formed lonsdaleite. Researchers are still working on what that reason is and on the exact conditions of that shock. But if they can figure it out, they could maybe find a way to create their own harder-than-diamond mineral. So far, the science is leaning toward rapid depressurization. Since uraeolites also contain minerals that exist deep inside the Earth, they all probably started off under a lot of pressure. But when the dwarf planet got blasted apart, all its insides would have suddenly been exposed to the near vacuum of space. One hypothesis proposes that upon this sudden change in pressure and temperature, the bonds between some of the carbon atoms could have suddenly shifted and morphed into diamonds' cubic lattice. Lonsdaleite came later. But a study published in 2022 suggests it's the other way around. The uralite's carbon atoms were shocked into forming lonsdaleite first, and most of that lonsdaleite shifted into diamond when the new meteorite cooled off quickly. So, if researchers hope to make not just their own lonsdaleite, but enough that they can run tests to prove it's harder than diamond, they need to figure out how to replicate this process. And to keep their new lonsdaleite warm enough for long enough not to decay into a diamond. There's actually been some success here. Back in 2021, one team claimed they'd not only made lonsdaleite, they'd also experimentally proven that their sample was stiffer than diamond. Now, geologically speaking, stiffness and hardness are two different properties, but you often find that stiffer minerals are also harder, so it's a step in the right direction. Unfortunately, the method they used was a bit, well, explosive. It destroyed the lonsdaleite they'd created almost as soon as they'd finished testing it. But if further research backs this study up, and the team can work out all the kinks, we could eventually have a reliable way to produce synthetic lonsdaleite. And if it does turn out to be harder than diamond, industry will love it. Because they're so hard, diamonds are used for all sorts of cutting, grinding, and polishing jobs. An even harder material would make tools even more effective and last longer. Maybe one day we'll all have lonsdaleite-tipped drill bits. And if we can make them big enough, people may rock some lonsdaleite bling and write a song about how awesome this space-based mineral is. Minerals rock. For more on minerals, you can check out this video's sponsor, Wondrium. Wondrium is a subscription service with videos about everything you've ever wondered and some things you've never imagined you would wonder, kind of like SciShow. To help you dive deeper, Wondrium has not one, but two programs all about minerals. That's 36 lectures on the nature of Earth as an introduction to geology, and 24 more lectures on practical geology. Through these programs, you'll learn tips for collecting minerals and how to identify the minerals you come across in your daily travels, using color, hardness, and other features. And because you're a SciShow viewer, you can get a free trial at wondrium.com/scishow or in the link in the description down below. Then you can subscribe for thousands of hours of wonder. Thanks for subscribing to all of the things from Wondrium to SciShow.